Welcome to Maths Companion. In the last two videos, we have discussed the section Sum of the Angles and we have done the problems also. Today, we are going to discuss the next section Outer Angles. Let us consider a triangle. We know there are three angles for a triangle and these are the three angles. Now, let me extend the side BC. Now I got a new angle here, which is outside the triangle. It is called an outer angle. Already there are three angles in the triangle. They are all inside the triangle and they are called inner angles or interior angles. Now at this vertex, we have an inner angle and an outer angle. What is the relation between these two angles? They form a linear pair, or the sum of these two angles is 180. Or we can say outer angle is 180 minus inner angle at that vertex. I have extended BC and I got an outer angle here. Now let me extend AC. I got another angle here, which is also an outer angle. Now is there any relation between these two outer angles? Look at these two lines. These are a pair of opposite angles. And we know opposite angles are equal. Therefore, these two angles are equal. Now, there is another angle at this vertex, this angle. Even though it is outside the triangle, it is not considered as an outer angle because these two are a pair of opposite angles, so they are equal. So, this angle is equal to the inner angle of the triangle. So, it is not considered as an outer angle. When we consider the outer angle of a triangle, it must satisfy some conditions. First of all, it must be at a vertex of the triangle. Secondly, it must be outside the triangle. Thirdly, it must make a linear pair with the inner angle at that vertex. Look at this angle. It is at this vertex. It is outside the triangle. And it makes linear pair with this inner angle. In the same way, this outer angle is at this vertex, it is outside the triangle and it makes linear pair with this angle. Now look at this third angle. It is at this vertex, it is outside the triangle, but it does not make a linear pair with this inner angle. So it is not considered as an outer angle. So we can see at this vertex, there are two outer angles, but they are equal. In the same way, you can extend these two sides, you will get two outer angles here and they are also equal. Similarly, when we extend these two sides, we get two outer angles here and we can see that they are equal. So generally, we can say we can make two outer angles at a vertex and they are equal, or the two outer angles at the same vertex are equal. So, when we talk about the size of an outer angle at a vertex, it doesn't matter which we mean. Now, we can draw outer angles at all the three vertices of a triangle. These are the inner angles. Now, extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Of course, you can extend like this also. Then you will get another outer angle at each vertex, but they are equal. Similarly, we can draw outer angle at all the four vertices of a quadrilateral. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. Extend this side. This is the outer angle at this vertex. These two angles are in a linear pair, or their sum is 180. And these two form a linear pair, these two form a linear pair, and these two also form a linear pair. Similarly, we can draw outer angles at each vertex of a pentagon also. Extend this side, this is the outer angle. 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 And as we have seen earlier, at each vertex, we can make two outer angles. I have made only one here, But we know both those outer angles are equal. These two are in a linear pair or their sum is 180. These two are in a linear pair. These two are in a linear pair. These two are in a linear pair. These two are also in a linear pair. Similarly, we can make outer angles at each vertex of any polygon. And we can see that the inner and outer angles at a vertex form a linear pair, or the sum of the inner and outer angles at a vertex is 180 degree. Now, let us do some problems. First problem, the angles of a triangle are 40 degree and 60 degree. Calculate all its outer angles. Let this be the triangle. Given that two angles are 40 degree and 60 degree, let this angle be 40 degree and this angle be 60 degree. Then what is the third angle? We know sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Therefore, this angle is 180 minus sum of these two angles. Sum of these two angles is 100 degrees. Therefore, this angle is 180 minus 100 or 80 degree. Now let us find the outer angles. Extend this side. We know sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Therefore, outer angle is equal to 180 minus inner angle or 180 minus 60. Therefore, this outer angle is 120 degree. Similarly, this outer angle is 180 minus inner angle or 180 minus 80. Therefore, this outer angle is 100 degrees. Outer angle is 180 minus inner angle. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 40 or 140. That means the outer angles are 140, 120 and 100 degrees. Second problem. Compute all angles in the figure below. Let us take the figure once again. Given that this inner angle is 35 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 35 or 145 degree. This outer angle is 105 degree. We know sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Therefore, this inner angle is 180 minus 105 degree or 75 degree. Now we have got two inner angles of the triangle. Let us find the third angle. 35 plus 75 is 110. Therefore, this inner angle is 180 minus 110 or 70 degree. Now this outer angle is 180 minus 70 or 110 degree. Next problem. Compute all outer angles of the quadrilateral shown below. Three inner angles of the quadrilateral are given. We have to find the outer angles. Let us find the fourth inner angle at first. We know sum of all these four angles is 360 degree. Therefore, this angle is 360 minus sum of all these three angles. 130 plus 70 is 200. 200 plus 60 is 260. Therefore, this angle is 360 minus 260 or 100 degrees. Now let us find the outer angles. This angle is 70 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 70 or 110 degrees. This inner angle is 130 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 130 degree or 50 degree. This inner angle is 100 degrees. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 100 or 80 degree. This angle is 60 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 60 or 120 degrees. Fourth problem. Compute all angles of each of the figures below. Let us take one by one. Here two angles are given. We have to find all angles. This angle is 145 degree. We know sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Therefore, this inner angle is equal to 180 minus 145 or 35 degree. This inner angle is 70 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 70 or 110 degree. Now, we got two inner angles of this triangle. Let us find the third angle. 70 plus 35 is 105. Therefore, this angle is 180 minus 105 or 75 degree. Now, this outer angle is 180 minus 75 or 105 degrees. Now, let us take the second figure. We need to find all angles of this quadrilateral. Given that this angle is 75 degree, therefore this outer angle is 180 minus 75 or 105 degrees. This inner angle is 100 degrees, therefore this outer angle is 180 minus 100 or 80 degree. This outer angle is 115 degree, therefore this inner angle is 180 minus 115 or 65 degrees. Now we have got three inner angles of this quadrilateral. We know sum of all the four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Therefore, this inner angle is 360 minus sum of these three angles. 65 plus 75 is 140. 140 plus 100 is 240. 360 minus 240 is 120. Therefore, this angle is 120 degrees. This outer angle is 180 minus inner angle or 60 degree. Now the next figure. This outer angle is 95 degree. Therefore, this inner angle is 180 minus 95 or 85 degree. This inner angle is 85 degree. Therefore, this outer angle is 180 minus 85 or 95 degree. This outer angle is 80 degree. Therefore, this inner angle is 180 minus 80 or 100 degrees. We have got three angles of this quadrilateral. Let us find the fourth angle. 85 plus 85 is 170. 170 plus 100 is 270. Therefore, this angle is 360 minus sum of these three angles, or 360 minus 270, and that is 90 degree. Since this angle is 90 degree, this outer angle is 180 minus 90 or 90 degree. Fifth problem. Prove that in any triangle, the outer angle at a vertex is equal to the sum of the inner angles at the other two vertices. Let us draw a triangle at first. Let it be triangle ABC. Let me extend BC. Now I got an outer angle here. At this vertex C, there are two angles, one inner angle and the other outer angle. Let me call this outer angle as angle ACD and the inner angle as angle ACB. We have to prove that outer angle is equal to sum of the inner angles at the other two vertices. Outer angle at this vertex is angle ACD. Inner angle at the other two vertices are angle A and angle B. So we have to prove that angle ACD equal to angle A plus angle B. Let us look at the three inner angles. We know sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. That is angle A plus angle B plus angle ACB equal to 180 degree. This is an equation. Let me take angle ACB on the other side. Then I can write angle A plus angle B equal to 180 minus angle ACB. We know sum of the inner and outer angles at a vertex is 180 degree. That is, sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Or we can say angle ACD plus angle ACB equal to 180 degree. This is also an equation. Let me take angle ACB on the other side. Then I can write angle ACD equal to 180 minus angle ACB. Now look at these two expressions. 180 minus angle ACB, 180 minus angle ACB. They are equal. Therefore, these two are also equal. We can see angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 minus angle ACB. And angle ACD is also equal to 180 minus angle ACB. Therefore, angle ACD equal to angle A plus angle B. Now, what is angle ACD? It is the outer angle at the vertex C. What is angle A plus angle B? It is the sum of the angles at the other two vertices. So we can say the outer angle at a vertex is equal to the sum of the inner angles at the other two vertices. Let us recall what we have learned today. The two outer angles at the same vertex are equal. Sum of the inner and outer angles at a vertex is 180 degree. That completes this section, outer angles. In the next video, we shall discuss the next section, unchanging sum. Till then, bye.